So another question I'm often asked is, well, what kind of tips can I provide students as they prepare for the CPA exam? I'm going to start with one that may seem a little bit strange. Give yourself permission to take a break. One of the mistakes that a lot of candidates make is they see this as, all right, here we go. It's time for me to shut down everything else in my life except the CPA exam because I'm going to do it 24/7. Forget sleep. It's overrated. And you can't. This is a marathon, right? There's a ton of knowledge that you have to go through for the exam. And your brain simply is not going to cooperate if you try to force feed it 24/7. So when your brain tells you, if you try to put one more tax regulation, one more FASB section in here, I'm going on strike, it's time to take a break. I always tell candidates, make sure you know what your recharge, your go-to recharge activity is. Maybe it's making sure that once a week you're able to go have dinner with your family. Maybe it's going to the gym for a workout to let loose some of that stress. Maybe it's watching a favorite movie on a Saturday night. Whatever it may be, whatever helps to kind of take you out of that exam review space and let your mind reset is critically important. Second, a lot of this is about efficiency. We talk a lot about efficiency. And part of that is to make sure you are not spending time unnecessarily as you study. For example, in college, students are used to working through homework exercises, and if they don't know the answer, the first resource they typically turn to is their textbook. They go back to the textbook, they go back to the notes, trying to ferret out, all right, where was that discussed? I don't remember that. Because you're used to doing that, a lot of students sometimes will do that as they review. They go to the textbook. Well, except that's not a good idea. So here's my first piece of advice. As you work through a multiple choice or a simulation, the first line of defense is the explanation. If you work a question and you miss it, and you read the explanation, and you can clearly understand why the wrong answer that you chose is wrong, why the other answers were wrong, and why the correct answer is right, and you can look at yourself and say, no, I won't miss that again, that's all you need to do. You don't need to go back into the textbook at that point and find the relevant page. Now, if you read that explanation, you say, I don't remember that at all. This is where we try to build tools that help. So you can click on link to lectures. You can see, okay, let me find out where that was in the book, or let me listen to that one page worth of content. You see, it's a lot more efficient to listen to one page worth of lecture audio or one slide worth of lecture audio than an entire lecture. Even if that only saves you a few minutes, that adds up in a hurry. Finally, for simulations, another mistake that some candidates make is they think, well, I've done standardized tests before, and the bread and butter of standardized testing is multiple choice, right? We think back to the SATs and the ACTs and those giant books just chock full of multiple choice questions. Now, multiple choice are very useful, no doubt about it. They are fantastic to confirm your conceptual understanding, right? That idea of, okay, do I really know what this means? Do I know how this works? Multiple choice are really good diagnostics for that. But with the exception of the ISC exam, that's only half of your score. And on the ISC exam, it's only 60%. The rest is simulations. So if you're spending X hours on multiple choice, you should be spending the same X hours on simulations insofar as that's just as important to your score. Unfortunately, we know that some candidates will emphasize multiple choice and then they will cut corners on simulations. Don't do that. It is too critical, and frankly, a lot of the points that you can earn on simulations should be straightforward and easy. Don't miss out on getting those points just because you overfocus on multiple choice. So those are a few tips that I can offer.